today we will start with class 6 geography. First of all, I know that this subject geography is completely new for you. Let me introduce what geography is. Till class 5 you have studied social studies, general science, that means science, social studies and science. When you come to class 6, science get divided into three parts, that is biology, chemistry and physics. Same way, social studies has also separate parts.
Shape and location of the oceans and continents. It
also shows the correct position of places in relation to one another. However, a globe has the following limitations of the globe. You understood, it's a 3D model of the earth, and by seeing a globe we can easily understand about the location of different continents and different oceans, but only up to some extent. Let me show you something here.
Have been developed. A map is a representation of the earth as a whole or a part of it.
drawn to a scale on a flat surface. Although less accurate than a globe, a map is definitely more useful. More or less, if we consider map not exactly the very same, but at least in comparison to a globe, maps are much more easy to understand and they easily help us to reach our destination. A map includes a title. Now, what all things we can see in a map? A title. What title is? That map is shown is of which place? India, North America, England, that particular place, that title of the map. Then scale, scale we are going to talk further. Directions, north, east, west, south. Grid system, conventional signs and symbols. And all colors show the different variety of information. Like green color shows a different thing. Blue color, different. Blue is for water bodies. Brown is for like mountains, plateaus, hills. Yellow is for desert. Yellow is also used sometimes for agricultural land. Green is for vegetation area, forest area. Blue is for water bodies. And red dot is used as for capitals of a country, capital of a state. And capital of a country. And then black color is for road, railway, different. We have different colors, signs and symbols. And in this chapter, we will learn them one by one. All these features are termed as the language of a map. Let us read about them. Scale. In India, we follow the metric system in which long distance are measured in kilometers and short distances in meters. The distance between any two points on a map is measured in centimeters. We measure the straight line distance between any two places of a map and relate it with the distance between the same two places on the ground. Now, what scale is? Not that scale that the ruler that you use.
Correct location and with the correct calculation also.
The distance between any two places on a map measured along a straight line is called a map distance. A straight line. That is called as a map distance. The distance between the same two places on the ground measured along a straight line is also called the ground distance. Map distance, another ground, ground distance. The ratio between the map distance and the ground distance is called the scale of the map. Suppose that scale of a map is 1 centimeter and it says that 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. This means that a distance of 1 centimeter between two points on the map corresponds to a distance of 1 kilometer in actual between the same two places on the ground. Are you getting my point? If I am talking about a map, this is suppose that 1 centimeter. But the scale of the map tells me that 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. This 1 centimeter is on a map and this 1 kilometer is on the ground distance. Now from reaching to one, from one place to another place, if the map says it is, suppose that it is 3 centimeter. From reaching from this point to this point, if it is 3 centimeter, that is a map distance. What is ground distance? 1 kilometer. That means 3 into 1? 3 kilometers. So actually when I will start walking, it will be 3 kilometers. But to understand here, to make it a little easy, it is using 1 centimeter, which tells me that every map has a different number. Now imagine, okay? Forget about this one. Suppose that this is a map. Got it? I'm standing here. I have to go here. This is my way of reaching to this place. This is my way. I'm standing here. I have to reach here. And this is my map. The scale says of the map that 1 centimeter is equal to, let me take 1 kilometer. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. Or why 1? Let me take 2 kilometers. In my map it is 1 centimeter is equal to 2 kilometers. Now 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 5, 6, 7 centimeter, 8 centimeter, 9 centimeter, 10, 11. Suppose that. From reaching to this place, for me it is 11 centimeter. When I start, this is my map distance. When I start calculating 11 into 2, that is on the ground I will have to travel 22 kilometers to reach from here to here. This is ground distance, this is map distance. Because you cannot draw the entire area on a piece of paper. So just to understand it, they make it simple by making it in short way. The scale of the map can be shown in one or more of the following ways: by a statement, by a numerical fraction, by a graphic or linear scale. Let us have a look at it. By a statement. In the statement method, the scale is stated as 1 centimeter is equal to 2 kilometer. In this statement, 1 centimeter is the map distance and 2 kilometers is the ground distance. That is what I was telling you here. This is a quick and easy method of using the scale to measure the distances. Simple. By a numerical fraction. The numerical fraction method is also referred to as the representative fraction, that is RF. In this method, the ratio between the map distance and the ground distance is given as in a fraction whose numerator is always 1. For example, the representative fraction is given as 1 by 1 lakh. In this example, the numerator 1 represents the map distance and the denominator 1 lakh represents the ground distance. So, the representative fraction says map distance by ground distance. Map distance by ground distance. Map distance is always 1 and ground distance it can change. This is numerator, this is denominator. Fraction way. In a fraction way, it can also be written as 1 is to 1 lakh, that is in the ratio sense. No particular unit of measurement is used with RF, representative fraction. It has a universal application in map making. It can also be converted into a statement, and the statement can be converted into representative fraction. For example, calculate the representative fraction when the statement of a scale is 2 cm. And the map says that 2 centimeters on a map and on the ground it is 5 kilometers. First, change both the sides to the same units of measurement. 2 centimeter is equal to 5 into 1000 meter. For calculation, we have to bring that centimeter into centimeter, meter into meter. So here, when it is talking about centimeter, we will talk in such a way. Then 2 centimeter, the calculation has been shown here. 5 lakh, and how then it is 5 lakh has been divided by 2, so 1 centimeter according to the ground distance it will go 2,50,000. Now drop the units of measurement from both the sides, thus the statement will be 1 is to 2,50,000 and its corresponding refraction will be 1 by 2,50,000. Got it? Two ways of calculating. By representative fraction we have to calculate and finding a statement of a scale. Go through this example 1 and 2, just a numerical thing, nothing else. By a graphic or linear scale, in the graphic or linear scale method, the map distance is shown with the help of a straight line. The length of a line depends on the size of the map. It is usually between 12 cm and 20 cm. This line is divided into parts known as primary divisions. Usually, the first primary division is further subdivided into smaller parts known as secondary divisions. For convenience, the starting point or zero point on the linear scale should be after the first primary division from the left. The primary divisions are to the right of the zero and the secondary divisions are the left of the zero. The linear scale is useful to measure the distance directly from the map. It also gives the figures or values of the corresponding ground distance. Anything else regarding this one? No. So a graphic or linear scale. Yeah, graphic or linear equation. In the graphic or linear scale method, the map distance is shown with the help of a straight line. With the help of a straight line. And somewhere we will have a point zero. Usually we have this from 12 to 20 centimeter. We take it approximately. It is divided into two ways, primary division and secondary division. Primary division and secondary division. That means this primary division, whenever it will go towards the right side, it will be primary division. And whenever it will move towards the left side, it will be secondary division. For convenience, the starting point or zero point on the linear scale should be after the first primary division from the left. The primary divisions are to the right of the zero. Right side of the zero is primary division. And the secondary divisions are to the left of the zero. The linear scale is useful to measure the distance directly from the map. It also gives the figures of values of the corresponding ground distance. It can be divided into several parts. Secondary division is divided into several parts. And this is another way of finding the map distance on the ground distance or in comparison to the ground distance. Types of maps according to scale. According to scale 3, there are two types of maps. Small scale maps, large scale maps. Small scale maps. The small scale maps show a very large area with less details. The maps in an atlas and the wall maps used in classrooms are small scale maps. The small scale maps give a general picture about the physical, climatic and economic conditions of a different region. Small scale map gives us the detail, gives us a general picture about the physical, climatic, economic conditions of a different region. And large scale maps, the large scale maps show a very small area in detail. The cadastral maps and the topographical maps are large scale maps. So now we can write it this way. Let us write here small scale.
On the map or on the ground are always
the north. If we know the north, then of course it is easy to find out the other directions. There are four main directions on the map: east, west, north, south. They are called cardinal directions. Once of the four main directions are marked, we can find the intermediate directions.
Survey, relief, land use. At least you just learn these